Hi, and welcome back with another great episode of Fun with Bones and Bob. Bones. Just to be clear, Bones, Bob, not the other way around. All right. Now we have a skull, just to be clear. And Bob's going to tell us what he can glean from looking at the skull. And then we are going to read the super secret diagnosis of what we think it is. And we're going to see who's right. Take it away, Bob.
All right, thank you. I think when we look at this skull, we can all recognize something's wrong. We've got something that happened to this individual's face and the frontal bone. And you can see something entered the skull right above the eyes, right in the middle of the eye and right above the right eye orbit. Mm-hmm. And you can see what it's done here. It's got a fracture that ran all the way up and it stopped at one of these sutures where the bones join. So this is a little bone biomechanics. We don't have to get in that now, but this is a really interesting case. And just by 5 seconds of looking at this, we can tell what happened to this individual. And Anna will tell us.
Yes. Believe it or not, I actually am a forensic anthropologist.
Yes.
Okay, so I can actually tell you that this is the result of some sort of very serious traumatic injury. It could have been a ballistic injury, or it could have been some type of shrapnel injury, and we have to look closer. All right, today's word of the day, ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about beveling. So sometimes we have to talk and see, you can look at some of the trauma and see if there's any beveling that'll help tell you if it's a ballistic trauma. So Bob, do you see any beveling, yay or nay? Or are we talking of a gunshot? Are we talking shrapnel? Because you can have a bullet is a high velocity weapon, but also you have mortar rounds, you have shrapnel, you have other things that you might see in a type of warfare situation. So this person obviously died a violent death, but did they die a violent death perhaps in a warfare situation or of a more domestic situation? How and how could you tell based on that?
Well, if we're a forensic anthropologist looking at this, we're going to first of all see all the damage that's caused to the face. Most of the facial bones are gone, the nasal area is gone, but what we do see is, aside from this fracture here, and a fracture that's outlined in black here on the side of the face, what we've got is we've got a circular hole right above the eye. And a circular hole like that typically is indicative of a gunshot wound. So when a bullet goes through bone, it's going to punch an oval or round hole in the bone, and when it exits the bone, like the skull, which it did not do here, it's going to cause a bigger hole to form. So we've got one small hole in the front above the orbit, and that looks to be a gunshot entry wound, not an exit wound. So the bullet went into the skull and did not exit it.
Ouch.
Yes.
All right, so we think we have a bullet wound, entry wound, and not an exit wound. All right, let's see what the card says. Large hole in anterior fossa of skull caused by through and through gunshot wound, probably a rifle bullet entering right orbital ridge with exit in left superior maxilla. So that's different. Linear fractures of frontal bone, extensive damage to nasal cavity, both orbits and left superior maxilla. There you go. Death from brain injury and infection, but here's the kicker. Are you ready for this?
Yes.
After 2 days. So believe it or not, with all this, still took 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
So it turns out there was an entrance wound and an exit wound, but it couldn't actually see the exit wound here. So
right,
you know,
and that's the difference in being forensic anthropologist and forensic pathologist. So the pathologists back then, or whoever the surgeons were who dealt with this individual, they would have been able to witness that the bullet entered here, and I thought the bullet would have entered like this and blew out the face, which is typical. But the doctor would have been able to surmise that the bullet entered like this and went out the facial region. That's why there's no exit wound in the back of the skull.
Interesting. I think that was a very, very special, very informative episode of Fun with Bones and Bob.